WEMF Radio Now.
USA Freedom Act.
Yes.
Right? So that's kind of where the campaign for digital Fourth Amendment rights takes a more national standpoint,
yeah.
Right?
And a lot of that advocacy has been happening through Restore the Fourth, which is more of the national vehicle. And that's a national organization that's got 25 chapters across the country. And Digital Fourth is essentially the Restore the Fourth of Boston. But the USA Freedom Act, we would not have seen any legislation of any kind coming out of Congress on the matter of surveillance because, understand this, all of these people who are making these decisions and bringing forth this legislation are being watched. Most of them have been targets of the NSA themselves. The NSA has their secrets in a vice. And so it is very difficult for any legislation to come through from Congress on this at all. And there are a lot of people in Congress who are both angry and scared that they have had to do anything even superficial to try and correct this.
Hmm.
So
you're saying basically that the NSA is spying on Congress.
Yes, it is.
Who makes the rules and applying pressure that way, maybe even blackmailing them.
That's
what you feel? Do you really?
There is some evidence of it. There was a whistleblower before Snowden whose name was Russell Tice.
That's right.
Who said, look, I'm former NSA. I held in my hand the evidence that the junior senator from Illinois, black guy with jug ears, you may have heard of him, was targeted during 2004 to 2005. That's the guy. Also Hillary Clinton, John McCain, they were covering their bases, members of the House Intelligence Committee, members of the Senate Intelligence Committee, people who were on the Foreign Intelligence Surveillance Court, basically anyone who has the ability to affect the budget or operations of the intelligence services.
Unbelievable. And it makes sense. That would extend, I would guess, to major media reporters, NBC, ABC, CBS. If you're a celebrity, maybe has a lot of power. That's an activist.
We don't have evidence that it doesn't. Russell Tice did not come out of the NSA with proof that it has happened. It's possible that Snowden did.
Yep.
We don't know for sure yet.
Well, that even extends to local government, right? Because you had the BRIC Fusion Center. Actually saw this from Chris Ferrone. They were actually watching Marty Walsh. They had their eye on Marty Walsh, while he was running for mayor.
You mean suspicious proto-communist Marty Walsh?
Yes. I mean, he's a Neanderthal in a different way.
He's got really nice hair, though.
Yeah. I mean, he's not, I shouldn't be so mean. He is actually pretty good in a lot of ways, actually. Unfortunately, I don't agree with him on the marijuana issue, but he is good in a lot of ways, and he's pretty centrist. He's pretty establishment. He's not like a radical.
I've honestly only ever heard bad things about Marty Walsh, to be perfectly honest with you. I've never heard any, bright shining pros of Marty. So I'm not the person to ask about that.
But truthfully, I think it probably does not rise to the level of them feeling like they have to go and target every state rep.
Sure.
But I think that once you start to play a role on the national stage, and being the mayor of Boston is a pretty good
national
deal,
yeah.
Then, I think that it's entirely possible that they'll want to start keeping tabs.
And that's the next thing that's coming out. Glenn Greenwald and Snowden, they're coming out with a list, apparently.
Of people who have been targeted.
Yeah, people who have been targeted. And it's going to be so surprising to see, I think, for people, when they realize, it's going to be exciting when the politicians all realize, if they don't already. I think a lot of them understand that they're targets and they've been spied on. But I think it's going to be a good thing when it's confirmed.
I think it has to be confirmed. It has to be proved. Because what politician is going to come to their public and say, actually, I do not rule in this state. I'm not the one, none of the people in this thing we call the Senate. We're not really in charge here.
I know. And who's really in charge? The intelligence, the military intelligence, the
espionage, that's a really interesting segue. That's a really interesting segue because now let's get a little international, right?
Should we take a break first, though?
Is this big? It's a kind of a rabbit hole, so we should break real quick.
Should we tease it? Why don't you tease it?
So right now at the Bilderberg.
Yes, gonna get into conspiracy stuff.
At the Bilderberg
Jones
meeting. Well, no, you have the former head of the NSA is one of the MCs.
Oh, really?
Of this year's Bilderberg.
Oh, God.
Is he beatboxing?
He is actually breakdancing.
You have the
oh, I want to see that.
The UK equivalent from MI6 doing.
I just wonder if he, like, if they sponsor like all the audiovisual and technical stuff. They're like, you know, well.
No, the one.
So they can easily spy. I mean, they must spy on everyone there too, right?
No, the one from MI6 is going to be quoting Tennyson. Isn't that what we do?
Yes, yes. He will stand there with an open book and a hand outreached like Hamlet. And, yes, we. All right, that's enough. We're
so
going to take
a break. What are we teasing?
We were teasing wanted to talk about how the NSA and all of these different organizations, you know, like Google, is all upset because they're being spied on by the NSA. But at the same time, Google is now hobnobbing with a former NSA executive chief, you know, at the Bilderberg Group. And all these people, the whole point of the Bilderberg this year is privacy.
And they're killing the American tech business. I mean, American technology is supposed to be number one. That's what we're actually doing well in, and I swear to God that these folks are trying to kill this industry. We'll take a break. It's the phone number. You know it now. What is the phone number, Frank?
It is 617-500-7100. And,
EMF Radio.
That's right.
We're the Young Jerks.
Presented by Greenleaf Magazine.
Yeah.
Buy my miracle food.
Take a break, and we'll be back with our special guests. We're talking all about spying, surveillance, digital Fourth Amendment rights with Alex Matthews. If you have any questions, give us a call. We'll be back. We're going to take a break. I think we're going to listen to really good music right now.
Radio nice. Now.
Keep listening.
WEMF. Radio Now.